So a very good afternoon to one and all present here. I welcome our expert Dr. BVSN Murthy from Engineers India Limited in this third day session of Faculty Development Program on Electrical Distribution System Analysis with Renewable Energy Sources. So before starting lecture of Dr. Murthy, I would like to introduce him to all the participants connected. So Dr. BVSN Murthy Vallam is presently working as manager in Electrical Department of Engineers India Limited, Gurgaon, Haryana. He received BTech in Electrical and Electronics Engineering from JNTU, Andhra Pradesh in 2010, and Master degree and PhD both from Power System from NIT Kurukshetra in 2013 and 2020. He has industrial experience of 7 years in Engineers India Limited. His work experience include basic electrical system design, sizing of electrical equipment, system studies, preparation of MR tender, technical bid evaluation, and preparation of technical queries. These industrial work and his research interest includes power system, distribution system, microgrids, distributed generation, reactive power management. He has published 16 research papers in international journals, 14 in conferences, and 3 book chapters. He has awarded with prestigious POSCO Power System Award for best thesis on all India level, rank 1. He also received Young Scientist Award from Vidya Good Association Pondicherry, Tata Rao Award from Institution of Engineers India, and Gold Medal in M.Tech Topper from NIT Kurukshetra. Gold medal in intermediate district first rank and best paper award from many paper, and he is editorial board member of American Journal of Electrical Power and Energy System. So with this brief introduction, I am handing over the session to you, Dr. Murthy. So over to you. So you may start now.
Thank you, sir. In this session, my topic is distribution system analysis using general object modeling systems. In this session, we will touch upon what is the application of GAMS and what is the basic features of GAMS, what is the general remarks, what is the structure of GAMS, how to write the equations, what are the solvers available in GAMS, how to read GAMS output file, and we will see some examples of GAMS. And the important one is GAMS Data Exchange and MATLAB GAMS Interface. Apart from this distribution side, we will touch upon the load flow analysis of radial, mesh, balance, unbalanced systems, and economic load dispatch problem, distributed generator sizing, capacitor sizing, and energy dispatch. So we will, in the first part, we will touch upon the GAMS software part, and we will see what are the programming part in GAMS. So there are many applications of GAMS available in various sectors, like that is agriculture, economics, engineering, management science, business, statistics, finance, stochastic program. So all these applications are available in GAMS model library. Users and research scholars can be access these model library programs from this model library. I will show how to access this model library from GAMS software. So, are you able to see GAMS window, this one?
Yes, visible, Murthy, visible.
So this is the model library. So from this model library, GAMS model library is available. If you click on the GAMS model library, all these applications are available. If you see, these are the agriculture economics based examples, then applied general equilibrium applications, then mathematics, then energy economics, economic development, engineering applications. There are so many sample example problems, programs are available in GAMS. So once you want to do research work in their PhD or M.Tech level, first users can access this model library. So understand the syntax of GAMS, how to write the equations, how to select the solvers, and which solver you have to use. So first understand this basic model problems, then you can start your work. And GAMS, this is the GAMS website. You can download the trial version from GAMS website here. Presently, the latest version of GAMS is 30.1. And what is the basic features of GAMS? See, GAMS is a high-level modeling software which is very fast computing software to solve complex large-scale modeling applications. It can solve linear, nonlinear, mixed integer, nonlinear problems. So all these problems can be solved using GAMS software by using a suitable solver. First of all, linear, you can linear one solver is available for nonlinear, one solver is available for mixed integer, another solver is available. So what are the solvers available in GAMS for different problem? Those solvers we will see in the subsequent slides. And these solvers are very high performance solvers, and we can compute the your problem very fast. Okay, so a very wide range of applications like academic and business applications are available. One important thing is GAMS will take only algebraic equations. So what are the equations you are having, what are the input parameters you are having, you have to give in the algebraic form only. So first of all, you are having an impedance equation, Z is equal to R plus Jx. So you cannot simply write Z equal to R plus Jx like you will write in MATLAB. So you have to write the resistance part separately and reactance part separately. Then you have to take the absolute value in GAMS. So we will see how the algebraic equations can be written in GAMS. Then what are the general remarks of GAMS? In GAMS, it is a collection of statements. What are the input parameters, input data you are having, you will enter as a statements. Okay, and the equations what you are having, what you are entering, there is no need of entering the equations in order. First, suppose there are 10 equations are there, and I am writing equation 1 first, then equation 3, then equation 5, then equation 10. But in MATLAB, you have to write all these equations in a sequential manner. That is not required in GAMS software. Another one, GAMS is not case sensitive. You can use the lower cases and upper cases, whatever it may be. And if you want to comment any equations, you can simply use the star symbol, beginning of the statement. So it will take as a comment file. So it will not considered in the calculation of while calculating your programming part. In GAMS, there are two files are there. One is your input file, that is .gms file. Another one is output file, that is listing file. So once you will write the program in GAMS, that is your GMS file, .gms file. Once it is executed, it will generate output file, that is listing file, .lst. So what are the results you want to display? That all these results will be available in listing file. And what is the structure of GAMS? The structure of GAMS consists of four parts. That is sets, parameters, variables, and equations. So what is meant by sets? What is meant by parameters? What are the variables? What are the equations? So you are having one problem. In that problem, it is consists of variables, correct? First of all, there is a two variables, x and y. Of your objective function, first of all, your objective function is 7 into x plus 8 into y. This x and y are your variables, and your objective function is, that is z equal to 7x plus 8y, and your parameters, there is upper and lower bounds of your variables are there. So that is to be defined as a input file. We will see here. See, this is the input file .gms and your output file .listing file. In the input file, as I said in the previous slide, you will declare all the sets as assignment members. Then you will define all the data. First, suppose a distribution network is there. In the distribution network of, for example, 33 bus, it is having 33 buses of 32 lines, 32 branches for a radial network. And each line is having resistance and reactance. So all these resistance and reactance and real and reactive power demand at each bus will be declared as a data. Okay, and in the sets, how many buses are there, how many lines are there, how many branches are there, that is to be defined as a sets. So what is your variable? Maybe your variable is calculation of losses, real and reactive power losses, calculation of voltage profile. So these may be your variables, and calculation of your real power flows, sending and real power flows, and receiving and real power flows, both real and reactive power flows. These will be the variables, and your objective function is minimization of total cost, minimization of total power losses. So minimization of voltage deviation. These will be your objective function. So you will define all these objective function. What you are considering in your problem, you will define as a equations. Okay. Then you have to select your model. You will select all the equations, all the variables, all the data you have entered, all the sets you have entered. You will model. Then you have to select a solver. Then you have to display what are the results you want to display. So what is the beauty of this GAMS output? It will generate what is the input you have entered as a echo print. It will repeat all the input data, input sets, input data, input variables, assignment, upper and lower bound limits, equations, and model statement you have selected, display statement what you have written. All this will be repeated in the output listing file. Then it will generate your results file. Okay. We will see what will be the output file, how to read the output file in the subsequent slides. So this is the sample economic load dispatch problem. In the economic load dispatch problem, I will display the GAMS program also. First, we will understand here. In the economic dispatch problem, I have considered 5 generators G1 to G5. Okay. Then what is your load demand? Your load demand is 400. Okay. And in the table format, I have entered the generators G1 to G5, minimum maximum power limits, and the cost coefficient ABC values. Okay, what is your variables in your economic load dispatch? In the economic load dispatch, your variables are generation and objective function, minimization of total cost. And what are the equations you will have? Equations will be A into B square plus B into P plus C. And ABC values are defined in the table. And P value is your variable. And second equation is power balance equation. What is the power generation is there? That should meet your load demand. In case you have considered the losses, so generation is equal to total demand plus your losses considered. And what are the limits in the generation? The generation should be greater than P minimum generation, and generation should be greater than the should be less than or equal to maximum generation. And you are having the model statement, correct? Followed by the solver. So what I am modeling all the equations, all the data, all the scalar variables, all the sets I have entered here. And I am using solver statement for minimizing objective function. And what is I am using solver? QCP, quadratic programming. Then what I am displaying? I am displaying the objective function value. I am displaying the power generation of G1, G2, G3, G4, G5. So in this program, what will be the sets and what will be the scalar and how to define table, you will see here. As I said in the general remarks, if you give a star symbol at the starting of the statement, starting of the equation, starting of the table, it will considered as a comment file. It will not counted in the programming part. Then, so these are the sets G1 to G5. Okay. Then the scalar variable demand, scalar variable that is load demand I entered. Table. The data can be specified as a tabular manner, listing file, or direct assignment. So, what are the methods for data assignment? We will see in the next slide. And these are the variables. What are the equations you are having? That is the equation 1 and equation 2 displayed. And you have modeled the statement. And you have used the solver statement. And you have displayed the results. So what is meant by what is meant by some disturbance is appearing, so please mute your audio. So
I am muted from my side. Okay.
Yes, sir. How to define sets? In the programming part, you have seen sets, scalar, tabular data, variable, equations, model. So these four are very important sets, defining the data and how to define your variables and how to write the equations. So we will see in the next slide how to write the sets, how to define your data and variables, equations. But suppose I am having n number of plants, okay, n number of plants, manufacturing plants of transformers, motors. So in the GAMS program, I have to define sets of I plants, transformers, motors. Similarly, there are J markets are there at a different locations. J markets at a Delhi location, at Mumbai location, at Madras location. First, suppose there is a 33 bus network. So I will define sets I buses 1 to 33. And for the 33 bus, you are having 32 lines. Okay. So you will define J number of lines 1 to 32. So this is the way to define sets. Okay. The sets can be defined in another manner also. First, suppose sets I. Okay. So this bracket symbol transformers motor and J bracket symbol Delhi, Mumbai, Madras. So in different ways you can mention your sets. Then another way of defining your sets. First, suppose there are 100 buses are there. So no need to define bus 1, 2, 3, 4 and 700. So simply you can define 1 into 100. It is of same meaning. 1 into 100 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 100. Similarly, first suppose you are running the programming for 24 hours or 8760 hours. So in that way, you will define T planning time period 1 to 8760. Okay, no need to write 1, 2, 3, 4, 8760. Then another important statement is alias. So you have defined T for that planning time period and M for a number of machines. Then I have used T for T1. So for this alias statement, I have used alias T comma T1. It means what are the sets you have defined in T, the same is copied to T1. So in the programming at a later part, instead of T, you have used T1. It is of the same sets as defined in T. Okay. Then data entry can be done in distinct manner, tabular manner, direct assignment manner. Okay. So data entry by listing manner. First, suppose you are having a plant capacity of transformer motors, 350 transformers, 500 motors. So instead of writing this data in tabular manner, as this is a simple data only. This is not bulky data, so no need to write in a tabular manner. And I have defined this data directly as a parameter, A of I, capacity of the plants, transformers, and motors, followed by the semicolon. Otherwise, you can give the semicolon after completion of all the parameters. Okay. Then data entry by tabular manner. First, suppose you are having data at two different locations, Seattle and San Diego, New York, Chicago, Topeka. This is the distance in a thousand of miles. Okay. So from Seattle to New York, 2,500 miles, and Chicago 1.7, Topeka 1.8. So like this, I have entered the data in tabular manner. The same can be entered for typical example of distribution network. What as I said, you are having 1 to 33 buses and 1 to 32 lines. So each bus having a load demand of real and reactive power demand. So you will define at real power demand, this is the reactive power demand, and buses 1 to 33. So you will enter real power demand here and reactive power demand here. Similarly, you are having here resistance and reactance from bus 1 to from nothing but sending and bus to receiving and bus. So you can enter the resistance here and reactance here. So in this way, you can enter the bulk data in tabular manner here. Direct assignment. Direct assignment is, for suppose you are having a load demand of 100 kilowatt. So I have entered scalar load demand 100 kilowatt here, and I want to convert this load demand into per unit. So this load demand, okay, is equal to load demand divided by base MVA into 1000. Directly I convert the load demand in kilowatt or megawatt into per unit. Similarly, resistance and reactance in ohms to per unit here. So this is the purpose of data entry in tabular manner and assignment manner listing file. Then variables. So your variable may be positive variable or negative variable or binary variable or integer variable, maybe free variable. Free variable nothing but it will be minus infinity to plus infinity. So before giving the variable type in your programming problem, so you will be very careful whether you have to define as a free variable or a positive variable or negative variable, because what are the constraints you have given, what are the data you have entered, and what are the solver you have selected. So it will depend your output variable type. Okay. Please take care while you are defining your variable. So I will give you one example. In case instead of defining a positive variable, negative variable I have defined, so it will change your output result. Similarly, instead of integer variable, I have selected a binary variable. It will change your output result. So we will touch, we will see how it will change your output file. Okay. So I am opening one example. So this is the example for variable. In this example, I have considered how many variables, x1, x2, x3, and your objective function z. So total 4 variables are there. And how many equations are there? You are having 3 equations, equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. So what is your objective function? Your objective function z is equal to 7x1 minus 3x2 minus 10x3. So in this example, I have considered x1 as positive variable, x2 as integer variable, and x3 also as integer variable. So I have modeled all the equations, all the variables what I have considered, and I have selected solver statement of mixed integer programming, because I am having a integer variable and a positive variable, okay, binary variables. In case I have selected binary variable, so mixed integer I have selected, and I am displaying x1 value, x2 value, x3 value, and your final objective function. So from this I am running the program here. So it is running. So one active process. So active process is completed. You can go to left side. This is the listing file. As I said in the previous slide, example variable dot listing. Your original file is example variables dot GMS file. Dot listing file is your output file. And go to display. This is the x1 value 210, x2 value 100, x3 value 100, and your objective function 1070. Okay. And go to your summary report. Just go up upwards. It will show solver status, one normal completion. Okay. If I change this binary, change the x2 integer variable to binary variable, and I am commenting this integer variable. So I am save this file. running this programming. So this active process is completed. Go to display file again, and this is X1. See, as I considered X2 as a binary variable, so it means X2 will be either 0 or 1. So to solve this your objective function, so X2 considered as a 1. Okay. So this is the purpose of defining properly your variables. Another example I want to quote here. For suppose you are having, if you want to place distributed generation and a capacitor in a distribution network. So for a typical 33 bus network, if you want to place n number of DCs, for suppose it will be, if you want to place 3 DCs, okay, these 3 DCs may be at second bus, third bus, or fourth bus, or 10th bus, what it may be. So GAMS will give 3 DC ratings at 3 optimal locations, correct? So for this, you have to define this DC variable as a binary variable. So you will define DC binary variable. Okay, so it will check all the buses from second bus to 33 bus. Yes, first bus is your source bus. It will omit that first bus, and it will consider all the remaining buses, that is first bus 2 to bus 33. So what will do GAMS? GAMS will select the second bus, and it will consider it as a binary variable. It means at second bus, DC 0 or 1. So in case it is selected as 1, and it will run the program, whether your objective function is fulfilled. In case your objective function is fulfilled, it will maintain DC at a second bus. In case your objective function is not fulfilled, it will maintain as a binary variable 0 at second bus. Like this way, you have to define your binary variables as per your requirement, as per your problem. Okay. Then this is the program I have considered just now as well. So this is the positive variable, integer variable, binary variable. In case if you not depend, it will take as a free variable. It means it will consider it as minus infinity to plus infinity. Just if in case you have defined as a simply variable, it means variable x1, variable x2, variable x3. So it will consider it as minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay. Already we have seen this this problem. Another one is how to write the equations. So first, suppose you are having one objective function, that is x1 plus 3x2 plus 3x3, okay, and x1 plus 3x2 plus 3x3, followed by following constraints. What are the constraints? You are having constraints x1 plus x3 is equal to 4, x3 plus x2 greater than 5, and x1 plus 2x2 greater than 3. So we will see how to write these equations in GAMS. So I'm opening that GAMS program. This is the one. So x1 plus 2x2 greater than or equal to 3, correct? So x1 plus 2x2 greater than or equal to 3, right? Then another equation is x3 plus x2 greater than 5. X3 plus x2 greater than 5. Then another equation is there, equation greater than 5, sorry, it is equal to 4, okay, we have considered equal to 4, so it will be is equal to 4. Then what is your objective function? X1 plus 3x2 plus 3x3, correct? X1 plus 3x2 plus 3x3. This is z. Okay, you have defined variable x1, variable x2, variable x3, and so I am defining as a positive variable. Positive variable x2, okay, x1, x2, x3, so all these are defined. So example, you have modeled and you want to display x1, x2, x3 and z. So let us run what it will say. Okay, so I think it is active process is completed. So is so it means it is not fulfilling any of your constraints what you have selected. Okay, so equal to and all these are variables, first variable. So I'm defining as a variable. So all these variables are defined. Okay. One more thing is, this is the what are the problem you have selected? That is the linear problem, correct? So presently, what is the solution it is giving? X1 value 0, x2 value 4, x3 value 0, and your objective function is 12. Okay. Then similarly, we will see another example also. So this is the syntax. First, suppose you are having equation symbol, then you will use syntax as equal to e equal to. Okay. Similarly, for greater than symbol, for less than symbol, addition, subtraction operation, multiplication, division, exponential. Okay. First, suppose you are having summation. Okay. Summation of j, xi j. So you will define as summation of sum of I j, xi j. Okay. Similarly, product of j, xi j. Then display statement. It is very important. So in the programming, you have seen that I have mentioned as a x dot l, z dot l, x1 dot l, x2 dot l, x3 dot l, correct? So what is l? L means level value, m means marginal value. And in case your variable x is having lower and upper bound values, you can define x dot low, okay, x dot up. So x dot low is your lower bound value, x dot upper is your upper bound value. And dot m, x dot m is your marginal value, x dot l is your level value. In case one of your parameter is fixed, otherwise in case you want to fix distributed generation at a particular place, at a particular node, so is a half second bus dot fx, so it will place dz at that particular bus. Okay, so this is a statement you can use to fixing a particular value. Then these are the legal characteristics. You can refer all these in the GAMS user guide, and I will show how to access the GAMS user guide. Go to GAMS, in the help, GAMS user guide is there, so you can download. It will generate a PDF copy. You can refer what are the syntax and how to write the equations, what is the statements, all this can be referred from this user guide. It is generating. Similarly, in the model library, as I shown, all these examples are available in the model library. So 1 minute, it is opening the user guide. Okay. So it is a 273 page document. So what we have discussed, all this will be available in the GAMS. What is the basic features of GAMS, how to write sets, definitions, data entry, data manipulation parameter variables, how to write the equations, model statement, solver statement, all these will be available in the user guide. Then in the model library, this is the model library, and this is the data utility library. We will discuss in the next slide, and just understand what is the data library. First of all, if you want to write the output file of GAMS to Excel file, then you can use the GDX file to transfer your output file to Excel file. First, suppose you are having a very bulk data in the output file. Okay, it means you have run the program for complete year. Otherwise, for 2-3 years, so it will generate the 2-3 years voltage profile, 2-3 years power losses, 2-3 years power flows. Okay. Otherwise, capacitor sizes, distributor generation sizes. Otherwise, your renewable energy voltage, your renewable energy power profile. This bulk data can be export from GAMS to your Excel files. Okay. What are the standard functions available? Similar to MATLAB, all these standard functions are available in GAMS. Like logarithmic, normal, uniform distribution, then absolute, okay, floor, max, minimum, modular, power, round, sine, square root, and trigonometric functions like cosine, sine, all these are available in GAMS. Okay. Like this is the continuous. Okay. Then this is the important. What are the solvers available in GAMS? See, your problem may be linear problem or non-linear problem or a mixed integer, relaxed mixed integer non-linear problem, or mixed integer non-linear program with integer variables, or quadratic constraint program, or mixed integer quadratic constraint program. So for each programming, GAMS is having a different solver. Okay, so we will see what are the solvers available. Based on your type of problem, GAMS will select the solver. See, first suppose you are having a non-linear program. This is the non-linear program. So what will use? GAMS will use the Cantor solver. Okay. First suppose you are having the linear programming. So it will use CPLEX solver. The same can be observed from the GAMS output file also. Once you have selected the non-linear program or linear programming or mixed integer, in the output file, what are the solver it is using, it will display in the output file also. Okay, whether it is used Cantor solver or CPLEX solver, based on your programming type, whether it is a linear, non-linear. Okay, no need to define Cantor or CPLEX. So GAMS will select automatically. Okay, these are the different solvers are available in the GAMS. So this can be accessed from the GAMS library also. So how to understand the GAMS output file? Okay, we will see here. This is the economic load dispatch. Okay, 5 generators we have considered, and load demand we have defined as a parameter. In the tabular manner, minimum maximum capacitors and the cost coefficients of each generator defined, equations defined. Okay, minimum maximum limits of each generator, generator 1 to generator 5 defined, and your objective function, that is minimization of total cost defined, and the power balance equation, that is generation is equal to load demand defined, and you have used quadratic programming of direction is minimizing objective function. So I am running this program. And see what will be the display file, that is listing file. Okay, so this active process is completed. I am going to this listing file, that is output file. So from the starting, it will say what are the GAMS version you have used. It is 23.5 version you have used. Okay, and what are the input file you have entered? The same is repeated in the output file. Then it will So the compilation time, the GAMS version again, and what is the solver using? That is PCP. Okay, and from which line you have used this solver? That is displayed, and we have, it is calculate the equation one. Okay, then equation two. Yeah. Then what are statistics? How many equations you are having? Two equations you are having, and how many variables you are having? Two variables, non-zero elements 11, derivative pools. Okay. So all these statistics are defined in the output file. And what is the generation time? 1.859 seconds. The execution time 1.859 second. What is the summary? So your model is. Your model is objective function. Okay, what is your objective function? OM. And what is your direction? Minimization. Okay, from where you have started? From line 27. And what is the solver you have used? Convert. Note that you have not displayed, you have not specified any solver in the GAMS input file. You have just simply specified as a type of problem, correct? PCP. So it will take as a convert solver as a given in the tabular manner. So it is normally completed. Okay, and it will then it will generate your understand here. So in each equation it will give the lower value, upper value, and the level value, marginal value. And for each generator, what is the lower value, what is the upper value, what you have already defined, no? Those values, and what is the marginal values? So those will be calculated. Finally, it will give the output file in the variable P. So G1 is 102 megawatt, G2 is 90 megawatt, G3 is 76 megawatt, and G4 is 77 megawatt, G5 is 53 megawatt. So total execution time is 0.16 seconds. And where it will be stored, your output file? Your output file location is also displayed in the last of the output file. So this is the way to understand the GAMS output file. So one example I am taking, transportation problem. So this transportation problem, we have studied optimization problem in a BTech and MTech level. So first of all, and the graph theory also. So that is the same equivalent to this transportation problem. So how to solve this type of transportation problem? So how to reach the demand location with the shortest path with the minimal cost? So this type of problem is transportation problem, and understand this one. This is the supply locations and this is the demand locations. Okay. This is the supply location, this is the demand location. Supply is 350 at Seattle and 600. Demand is 350, 350, 350. Okay. And the distance from each location to destination point is given in 1000 miles. Similarly, from second to each destination location is given in 1000 miles. Then what is your objective? Objective is minimization of total cost, correct? And parameter is total. Freight cost. Freight cost is nothing but based on your distance cost. That is $90 per 1000 miles. So this problem can be defined as you are having I number of sets, J number of demands. So I number of plants, J number of markets. And what is your cost? That is transportation cost. And transportation cost nothing but your $90. Okay. Then what is your variable? That is how many shipments to be shipped, and what will be the total cost? Okay. So your total cost will be minimization. So you have to depend as a minimization of IJ into XIJ. Okay. Another one is supply demand balancing. Okay, shipment from each plant should be less than or equal to supply capacity. Similarly, shipment at each market should be greater than or equal to demand. So these equations how to write in the GAMS. So I have defined sets I comma j and data entry at plant and at a destination at a demand level, demand point. Okay, and in the tabular manner as we have discussed data entry by listing by tabular manner. Okay, this is the tabular manner I have entered. Okay, distance from one point to another point, and your scalar cost, that is right cost, is defined is 90. So what will be your total cost? It will total cost is equal to freight cost into DIZ, that is from destination to your source to destination, and it will be total cost, that equal to CIZ into XIZ. This is the balance equation. So what it is giving variable is, it means 50 from this plant to New York, and 300 from Seattle plant to Chicago, and 0 from Seattle to Topeka. Similarly, from San Diego to New York 275, and 0 from San Diego to Chicago 275, from San Diego to Topeka plant. What will be the total cost? It is $153. Okay. This is the way to solve your transportation problem. So one best example for this using this transportation problem is reconfiguration of your network. The reconfiguration of your network, you will choose optimal path, correct? You will choose the shortest path by minimizing your branch losses and maintaining your voltage profile, correct? So that the similar this reconfiguration problem for can also be solved using this type of can be solved in GAMS in a similar way. So in that, what are the equation will be changed? The equation will be your I square R and I square X, correct? So this again R and X is a factor of your distance, really nothing but branch length. Similarly, reactance is the this factor of your branch length. So I square R and I square X is the factor of your distance. So you will maintain, you will reach your destination point from the sending end in the shortest path, maintaining your total maintaining feeding your total demand, and objective is minimizing your total losses. Similarly, in MATLAB and C language, conditional expressions are available in GAMS also, like if statement, okay, loop statement, and else if else statement, while loop, okay, while condition also can be done, for loop can be while loop can be done. So these conditional expressions also can be used depending on your programming requirement. In your code, you can use this for loop, while loop, and if else statements as required. Another important thing is MATLAB and GAMS interface. So why it is required? See, in case you are having a bulk data in MATLAB, okay, and you want to, you don't want to enter this bulk data from MATLAB to GAMS. Okay, simply you can transfer this MATLAB data as an input file to .gms file. Okay, then what are the programmings, what are the equations, what are the statements you are given in GAMS? From the from these equations, it will collect the data from the MATLAB, it will execute the equations what you have done. Okay, then it will select the solver as required, it will generate the output file. Finally, the output file also can be transferred to MATLAB. Finally, the output file is displayed in MATLAB window. Okay. So this type of interface can be done using MATLAB and GAMS. Another one is, if you want to write some equations, some calculations in MATLAB, Those can be done in MATLAB, okay, like for loop, while loop, or conversion of basic values into per unit data, like resistance and reactance into ohms per unit data, or your kilowatt and KVR load demand in your ATH bus to per unit. This type of calculation can be done in MATLAB, and two can be transferred to GAMS input file, and finally execution can be done in GAMS software. This type of can be done. Another important thing is data exchange, GAMS data exchange. This is very, very important. The objective of GAMS data exchange is, what are the output file you are having, okay, that to be GAMS output file to be transferred to GDX file, then GDX file can be transferred to Excel file. So to export the output file of GAMS, you have to use the GDX file as an intermediate. So what we'll do, GAMS will transfer the output file to GDX, then GDX to Excel. Similarly, if you want to import Excel file, Excel data, instead of from MATLAB, okay, if you want to import data from Excel, similarly, Excel to GDX, then GDX to GAMS. This is the way. So GDX is the interface from GAMS to Excel. The syntax of GDX is available in the link, GAMS data exchange module, the GAMS library. Okay. Then we will see economic load dispatch problem we have seen, and the optimal power flow problem also we will discuss here. So in the optimal power flow, what I have done, I have taken two buses. Okay. I have taken two buses, bus 1 and bus 2, and the exercise is the reactance between the bus 1 and 2. Okay. And what is the load demand at second bus? I have given here as L2 and X12, 0.2 per unit. And what is the base value defined? Okay. And P12 maximum power transfer, I have defined. What is the generation G1 and G2, minimum maximum levels? What are the cost coefficients of generator G1 and G2 defined? So your objective will be the optimal power flow. What is your objective? Your objective is minimization of your total cost. That is A into P square plus B into P plus C. And subjective to your constraint, that is balancing your total generation and load demand. Okay. And your power flow constraint, that is P12 is equal to delta 1 minus delta 2, nothing but delta I minus delta j by xij. What is your limit? Your limit, P12 limit already defined. Okay. And, so what I am using, as the equation consists of A into P square plus B into P plus C. So I am using nonlinear programming to minimize your objective function. So what is your ultimate aim? To calculate your P1, P2, and what is the total cost. So your objective function is 306, P12 is 1.5, okay? So this is the way to calculate your power flow equations. Okay? Then distributed generation and capacitor size. So in the distributed generation, the first thing is location of distributed generation. How many locations you want to place DC, and what will be the DC size. So these are the two things to be find in the problem. So in many literature survey, it is seen that sensitivity based methods are particle swarm optimization, or genetic algorithm, or anti-line optimization, gravitational search algorithm. Like this, there are so many optimization algorithms are available to find this location of distributed generation or capacitor and sizing of your DC. We will see what will be the benefit of what will be the advantage of sizing your distributed generation or capacitor in GAMS. We will compare the results in GAMS and other optimization software. So in this in the problem, what are the equations that will be required? The one is power balance equation, that is real power balance and reactive power balance, and power balance equations, power total power input intake from the substation and your locally distributed generation, that is PDG, equal to total load demand plus total losses. In case your DG is deploying reactive power also, then your equation will require change. That is total intake from the substation, that is plus reactive power support from the distributed generation, is equal to total load demand and total reactive power losses. In case your distributed generation is not giving any reactive power support, this term PDG will be zero. So the remaining thing will be same. Subjected to constraint. What are the constraint? Your voltage profile within the minimum maximum limits. In general, it will be 0.95 to 1.05 limits, and similarly delta minimum maximum limits and distributed generation within the minimum maximum limits. It will be first, suppose you are having a load demand of 3 megawatt, so you cannot place a DG of more than 3 kilowatt, 3 megawatt, correct? So there will be limit in the distributed generator sizing. Okay, similarly real and reactive power support, and similarly capacitor size. In the capacitor sizing, P plus P is equal to total demand plus real power losses, and Q equal to Q capacitor plus demand plus losses. Similarly, in case you are having OLTC tap position, then equation will be changed. Tap square.
What is that? Yes.
Tap square, VI square, GIJ. This is the power flow equations. Similarly, QI is a power flow, reactive power flow equations. Then your in the capacitor bank, you will have the series reactor. Okay, the series reactor is rating will be calculated as 3 into IX². Okay, so while sizing your total capacitor output, you have to consider the capacitor size calculated plus series reactor calculated using this equation. So total net capacitor size will be your calculated capacitor plus your reactor size. So while you are purchasing your capacitor, otherwise while you are installing your capacitor, please ensure that it is taken care the reactor rating also. Okay, so we will see distributed generator sizing first. Before that, we will see the load flow equation, load flow for radial, balanced, unbalanced mesh networks. Okay. See, if you are using MATLAB to solve this load flow, there are methods of forward backward method and based on finding out power and current basis. Okay, based on BIBC method, like this, these are there are methods are available to solve the distribution load flow method. And in this, we are using GAMS software to solve the problem. Please note that we will not use any calculation of BIBC, otherwise calculation of incident matrix as required in MATLAB. So this will GAMS will directly solve the your distribution load flow based on your power flow equations as given here. That is PIJ, QIJ. Okay. So go to your GAMS structure. Sets I have defined. Sets nothing but how many buses you are having, how many nodes you are having. Okay. How many lines you are having in the network? I am having 33 buses. I am having 33 lines. Okay, I am having the one grid network, that is the source network. Okay, then what are the I will touch this A and B in the next session, next slide also. Okay, and what is the parameters? This is the resistance you have to define for each line, and the reactors you have to define. What is the load demand? What is the reactive power demand? What is the sending end? What is the receiving end? How many nodes are there? So this is the your parameters of your test network, what you are having. For suppose 33 bus network, I have entered all this data, right? Nothing but resistance, reactance, load demand of real and reactive power, sending end node, receiving end node, number of buses. And what is the base data? The base data is 100 MVA, 12.66 kV network, and minimum maximum limits I have entered. So to convert your base data into per unit is equal to your base value divided by base MVA into 1000. So same equation as we write in MATLAB, the same can be written in MATLAB to convert base values into per unit values. And variables, what are the variables you are having? Your voltage profile, your power flow calculations, and your total power losses, real and reactive power losses. Okay, these are the variables in your problem. So as we see in this power flow equation, the same power flow equations I have written here. This is the equation 8 and equation 9. Pg is equal to sum of grid power taken, okay? Pg is equal to sum of reactive power taken from the grid. And equation 10, sending end power. And equation 11, okay, sending end reactive power. And what is the equation of sending end power? That is Bi square into J minus Bi Vj G into cos theta, like this, theta minus theta j plus b into sin delta I minus delta j, like this. Similarly, for the reactive power equation, okay, Vi Vj Gij sin delta minus Bij cos delta. So these are the basic power flow equations everyone know in the BTech level and MTech level. So these equations I have written. So apart from this equation, I am not calculating any BIBC matrix, otherwise any incident matrix. So nothing I am calculating, only power flow equations I have written here. So after power flow equations, I am calculating the losses, that is real power losses and reactive power loss. So in the beginning of GAMS, I have said it will not take any complex terms in the GAMS. So it will not take any Z plus, Z equal to R plus Jx. So you have to separate R resistance part separately, nothing but real part separately, imaginary part separately. So what are the equations you are having? So real equations separate, reactive power equations separate. Similarly, real power loss equations separate and reactive power loss equations separate. But in MATLAB, you can directly calculate loss, nothing but complex loss is equal to I square into Z. So in GAMS, I have separated P loss separate, Q loss separate. Okay. And in case if you want to model your load, you are having a number of load, constant power load model and constant current load model, constant impedance load model, battery charge load model, okay, lamp load model, chip load model, which nothing but a combination of impedance, current, and power load. So all these load models can be done here. First, suppose I have considered as a constant power load model. Nothing but P is equal to P base case value into V upon V power 0. First, suppose if I change to V square, so it will act as a impedance load model. If I change to 1, a constant current load model. Like that, you can change your equation. Okay, for example, if you want to write as a impedance model, so your impedance load model equal to P into V square, okay, into P into V, V power 1, that is current model, and V upon 0, correct? So these components, that is Z and CI and CP, so it will have some composition. Like in this case, I am considering 20% constant power load model and 20% constant current load current model and 0.6% as a impedance model. In this way, you can model your drip load model, otherwise your battery charge model. What are the model you are having, you can model. So presently I am maintaining as a constant power load. Okay, and after this load model, first of all you want to include the load growth also. So what will be the formula for load growth? Load growth is equal to initial load into rate, 1 plus rate whole power your planning period, correct? First suppose your load demand is there. Okay, that is initial load demand is P naught. Your initial load demand is P naught. So I am modeling this load real power load demand for 5 years with a rate of 7%. First suppose if you want to maintain 10% rate, it will be 0.1. So what it will do, it will first model your load model, whether it is a constant power load or a constant current, drip load model, whatever it may be. Then it will consider your load growth, what you have considered here. Okay. This is the way to include your load model and load growth in your equation part. So after that, I have given the voltage limits. Then model, then solver statement. This is the nonlinear programming. So I have used nonlinear programming, and I have selected objective function as minimization of PLT. PLT is total real power loss. Okay. First, suppose you are having a multiple objectives, nothing but minimization of real power loss and minimization of reactive power loss. Then you can define objective 1, objective 2. Nothing but objective 1, objective 2, okay, then objective 3, maybe this is voltage deviation, okay. So you will consider a single objective, combination of objective 1 and objective 2, objective 3, by giving some weightage to objective 1 and objective 2 and objective 3. So in this way, you can consider, you can include multiple objectives also in your programming part. Okay. So I am running this load flow problem. This is the radial network, 33 bus system. So active process is completed. So we will see the voltage profile. Say at node 1, that is the source bus, substation bus. As a 1 per unit, and a second bus 0.997, and similarly at node 33 0.91. What is your real power loss? It is 210 kilowatt, and what is your reactive power loss? 143 kilowatt, and total power taken from the grid, it is a combination of total load demand plus total losses. So this is the radial network. So we will see for the mesh network. So in case if you have anyone solved the load flow analysis in mesh network, they have to form two matrices, that is BIBC, BCBB for the radial part and the for the loop part, for the mesh part. Okay, but the same is not required in the in GAMS software. What are the node flow we have used right now in for radial network? The same can be used for the mesh network. I have nothing changed in the programming part. Simply, I have added only these 32 lines. Instead of 32 lines, I have changed it to 37 lines. Okay, it means in the mesh network, what I have considered here, I have included 5 meshes only. I have included 5 loops. Okay, what are the 5 loops? That is 33 line, 34 line, 35 line, 36 line, 37 line. Okay, apart from this, I have not changed anything in the radial part of the programming. The same program is applicable for the mesh network also. This is the advantage of GAMS, because it will calculate based on your power flow equations. But in MATLAB, if you want to solve these power flow equations, you have to write those BABC matrix, BCBC matrix. You have to solve for the radial network separately and mesh network separately. Then you have to calculate the voltage drop for the radial network and for the mesh network. Then you will get your output result finally. Similarly, we will see whether it is working or not. So I have reached an optimal solution here. So this is the voltage profile. Okay, 33 buses. And what is the losses? The losses will be 123.88.02 kilowatt. So another example we will see, that is unbalanced network. So in this unbalanced network, I have considered 25 bus system. As we know, for unbalanced network, for each phase, you are having resistance and reactance, real and reactive power demand, correct? So the, what are the programming presently we are using for a balanced network? Nothing but one single phase we have considered, correct? Coming to this unbalanced network, we have to write those equations in a 3 times, for R phase, for Y phase, for B phase, correct? Similarly, you have to enter the data for each phase. So R phase data, B phase data, C phase data. You know, these data will be for R phase self values and mutual values. So self resistance for R phase, B phase, C phase. Similarly, self reactance, A phase, B phase, C phase. Similarly, your mutual data, mutual resistance reactance. So all these data I have entered. And I have run the those power flow equations, that is PIJ, QIJ. So apart from this, there is nothing changed in this programming part. So for each phase, I have entered ABC, ABC, ABC. Similarly, calculation of losses, ABC. In each phase, I have entered equations in each phase, voltage, limits in each phase. Okay. So I have already reached optimal solution. So this is the your real power loss in A phase, B phase, C phase. And completing including all three phases, the total loss is 158. Similarly, A phase, B phase, C phase, reactive power losses. A phase, B phase, C phase, your voltage profile. This is A phase voltage profile. This is B phase voltage profile. This is the C phase voltage profile. So my advice to all the research scholars who are working in power system area. So in case you are not have touched upon this GAMS software, so look up. So learn this software. It will be very useful, and you can. Solve many problems using software easily. It will be useful for your further research work also. We will see distributed generator sizing and capacitor sizing problems. What are the power flow equations presently you are using? The same equations can be used to distributed generation sizing, capacitor sizing. So where will be the change? The change will be the your DZ will deploy, will support real power support, and your capacitor will support reactive power, correct? So this P and Q equation, power flow equations are there. Those two equations will change. Apart from this, there is no change. There is nothing change. In case if you want to include any objective function, those objective function can be included. Okay, let us see the distributed generator sizing, and you have to define how many DCs you are having, how many capacitor banks you are having. So in this problem, I have considered three DCs. So another variable, another set I have defined apart from this I and J. This set is for number of DCs, that is 1, 2, 3. So I have selected number of DCs as at first DC 30th bus, second DC 24 bus, and third DC 30th bus. Similarly, the data what we have seen, the resistance, reactance, real power demand, reactive power demand, sending and node data, receiving and node data, and the number of buses, base values, minimum maximum limits, conversion from base to per unit, what are the variables we have defined. One more variable it will be added, that is DC power output. So what will be the change? The change is equation 8. Previously, your equation 8 is this one. The total power is power taken from your grid. So in this case, the power equal to power taken from the grid and power locally deployed from the distributed generation. So this term, it is added. First, suppose you are having only one DC, then simply you can write PDC of K only. But in this case, I am having K number of DCs. So I have to sum all the DCs, correct? So sum of K, DC of K. In case DC is there at a particular bus, correct? So the remaining equation same. And in the display statement, I have added one more term, that is DC power output. So I am running the problem. So optimal solution reached. I am displaying the results. So your total real power loss is 72.49. The reactive power loss is 50.6. What are your DC ratings? Your DC ratings are the first DC 801 kilowatt, second DC 1091 kilowatt, third DC 1053 kilowatt. Okay. So in this example, we will change something. First, suppose I want to place 5 DCs. Okay. Simply define how many DCs you want to place in the sets. So for this, you have to give the number of DC location. Fourth DC, 15th bus, 5th DC, I have taken as 10th bus. So nothing I am changing. Simply I am running the this problem. So this problem, this output file should give the 5 DC locations, correct? DC1, DC2, DC3, 4, 5. And your total DC output, and your real and reactive power losses. This is the way to for finding your distributed generator sizing. Similarly, capacitor sizing. The same, just instead of DC, I have taken as capacitor. Number of locations I have taken as 2. And those locations are 12th bus and 30th bus. In the DC, I have added real power output from the DC in the power real power equation. But in the capacitor case, I have to add this equation, this capacitor reactive power support, the reactive power equation. Previously, there is no reactive power capacitor. So this equation will be simply grid power only, grid reactive power only. But in this case, grid power plus totally locally reactive power supported by the capacitor. So we will run. Sorry, it is not run. Okay. So it is solved. This is the real power loss 141 reactive power loss 96, your capacitors 464 kVAr, and second capacitor 1063 kVAr. So this way it will solve your capacitor and distributor generator sizing. So in case anyone is working in renewable energy area and you want to model your uncertainty of load demand, uncertainty of solar variable, solar power output, uncertainty of your wind power output, thing but solar irradiations and wind velocity. These are the two things to be modeled in your programming part. Thing but you have to consider the uncertainty of your load demand, uncertainty of your solar power output, uncertainty of your wind power output. So to handle this uncertainty, the GAMS, there is a stochastic programming part available in GAMS. So you can refer these functions like beta distribution function. You only use it to model solar irradiations. Okay, so normal distribution function for load distribution. Okay, Rayleigh distribution function, Weibull distribution function for wind speed. So these are inbuilt feature of GAMS. So you can use these distribution functions, and you can include those, you can solve those uncertainty in your programming part. So apart from this, we will discuss energy storage system, generator, distributed generator is energy storage system, and wind plus energy storage system. So so this is example one. In this example, I have considered generator, that is A into P square plus B into P plus C. So apart from this generator, I have considered some energy storage system. This energy storage system is controlled by your state of charge of your battery, correct? So this state of charge of battery and power balance equation, that is power generated and discharging power equal to total load plus your charging power of your battery storage system. These equations, these power flow equations, I have modeled in GAMS, and we will observe what will be the power output, what will be the load demand. So how you are meeting this load demand with your generator and with your storage system. We can see that this state of charge of your battery. So part of power is supplied from your generator, and at certain periods, some part of power is supplied from your storage system. Okay, this is the charging discharging at each hour. Okay, and power output of each generator, PG1, PG2, PG3, PG4. So how to solve this type of problem in GAMS? So for this, I have entered the data in tabular manner. For generators P1 to P4, I have taken, and cost coefficients ABC for each generator I have taken, and minimum maximum limits I have considered. Okay, time period I have considered T1 to T4. Okay, so in this case, no one to enter 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 24. Simply you can enter T1 into T4. So what are the equations you are having? This is the cost of your generator, that is A into P square plus B into plus C. Then what? Generator constraints. This PG constraints should be less than or equal to your upper value and the lower value. Okay, those are defined, and balancing equation, state of charge calculation and power balance equation. That is your generation plus discharge from the state of charge is equal to your total load demand plus your charging, battery storage system charging. So these equations I have modeled, and using quadratic programming problem, I have solved this model. So for each hour, 1 to 24, it will calculate your state of charge from 1 to 24. Then your discharging power then charging power, then your cost coefficients, okay? Then total power P1, P2, P4. So the same is depicted in the graphical manner. Similarly, in the battery energy storage system plus wind, I have considered. So in this case, what will be the change? The previous case, you are having only thermal generation, correct? So in this case, I have considered thermal plus diesel plus this wind. So your power balance equation will be generator power output plus wind power output plus your total discharge power from the battery energy storage system, load demand plus energy storage system. So apart from this, there is nothing changed. So we will see, you will see those change in the equation also. So this power balance equation is changed. Generator power demand, sorry, discharge plus wind power plus load demand plus energy storage system discharge. So in this way, this energy energy dispatch problems also solved. Okay. So that's all. In case any queries are there from programming part or any queries in the distributed generation sizing, capacity sizing, you can ask directly. Hello, sir.
Yes, Murthy.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So thank you very much for your elaborative lecture in this faculty development program.
Yes, sir.
So you have explained with examples very well.
Yes, sir. So I will share this basic program, sir. So this you can share it to. Who are the participated in this session? So this may be useful further their research work as a base programs. Further, in case they are having any queries in the program part also, they can directly contact through mail ID also, sir.
Okay, sure. I will share your mail ID also.
Yes, sir.
So now participants, if you have any question, you may ask right now directly if you have any question. Any participants having any doubt?
Good evening, Murthy sir.
Yeah.
This is Jiten Singh.
Yes,
sir. Sir, you have modeled DG in GAMS with active power and negative power capability. If I want to find the optimal power factor of DG, then
yes,
what changes I need to make in GAMS programming?
Okay. See, basically optimal power factor of DG is nothing but your total you are having total load demand, correct? Total, yeah, are you audible? You are having total real power demand, reactive power demand, correct?
Yes, sir.
So from this real and reactive power demand, calculate your load power factor. Okay, first suppose your load power factor is nothing but for total load demand divided by your complex power, correct? P by PD divided by SD, correct?
Yes, sir.
So in case, so this load power factor, in case this load power factor we have calculated as a 0.9 or 0.85 power factor. Okay, for example, for your test system, this load power factor is 0.85. This load power factor is your optimal power factor of your DG what you want to place. Nothing but in case your load power factor is 0.85, you have to place your DG at 0.85 power factor to obtain optimal benefits. Nothing but optimal results. Then you will get the optimal results, optimal losses, optimal cost, optimal voltage profile.
Okay.
So for this, what you want to do? I am opening this GAMS program. This is the GAMS program. Are you is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. So in equation in equation 8, I have modeled a PDG, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so sir. In equation 9 to be changed to incorporate reactive power support also. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So in equation 8, PDG, real power support you have added, and equation 9, reactive power support you have added.
Yes, sir.
Then you have to define power factor of the DC.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this DC power factor is equal to your load power factor.
Okay.
Okay. So this load power factor you have calculated as 0.85. Otherwise, you can write the formula also, PD divided by SD. Okay. So after this, your QDG equal to your PDG into tan 5. Okay. So Jitendraji, so you have defined your load power factor.
Yes, then, sir.
Otherwise, you can calculate the load power factor by using a formula SD divided PD divided by SD. Then your reactive power support is controlled by your, what is the power factor you are defining here? So QDC is equal to PDC into this this power factor. So in this way, you can place your DC at optimal power factor.
Okay, correct, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Sir, one thing
is it audio?
Yes, you can define. So in that case, what you have to define, you already know the load power factor, correct?
Yeah.
Huh.
Yes, sir.
See, Jitendra, you already know the load power factor, correct?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
If you want to calculate this power factor, give the range for this tan 5. So this tan 5 minimum should be less than 0.85, should be greater than is that correct? So in this case, what you will do, you already know the optimal power factor. So in this case, I am maintaining minimum as 0.8, maximum as 0.9. So automatically GAMS will give the tan 5 as 0.85. Okay. Hello, Jitendra ji.
Thank you, sir. It was my intention. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
No need to directly specify. Yeah. So this QDC will be controlled by your power factor.
Okay. Any other question?
Thank you so much.
Okay. So is there any other question from the participant? Okay, so everyone is appreciating your presentation only in the chat window. So if you have any further queries, you may directly contact to Dr. VVSN Murthy, and also you may refer his research paper or the material he has shown. Okay, so a basic program will be also shared to the participants.
Participant can be noted on this email ID in case required.
So participants can note down the email ID. So thank you very much, Murthy.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Nice presentation.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay. So, Aswini sir is here. Sir, your mic is mute.
Dr. Murthy, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
It's a pleasure that our signing student, Dr. Murthy, was with us today and delivered what he has carried out in his PhD thesis and how the GAMS can be applied for the microgrid operational management. So I am sure that all the participants must be benefited out of your talk, and they can use this very important tool as an optimization box, and they can carry out a lot of analysis. Okay. So for any further queries, the mail ID is given and you can contact Dr. Murthy for further queries and comments. So I